Hello guys, this is Tutorials, and today I'll be showing you guys how to create an awesome intro in C4D and Realflow, and this is going to be the preview of what we're going to be creating. So as you can see here, the water flows over the text and it freezes. It basically stops in place, and so it looks like kind of like ice, kind of like water freezing. So let's open up C4D and I've been experimenting here, doing stuff, but anyways, let's pretend that we just opened a new project. Let's go to MoGraph, MoText, and type in whatever you like for the text. Let's enlarge the depth and change the font to, let's see, Frosty's Winterland is the font that I like to use for this kind of intro. I actually use it in the preview I just showed you, which is an intro for our gaming channel, me and my friends' gaming channel. Anyways, once you have the text ready, once you've edited the text enough, you can select it. Select it in the objects menu and hit C on the keyboard, then right click, select children, hit C again and right click again, select children again, then right click again and select connect objects and delete. So now we have connected the whole text, so it's one whole text, so you can't, it's basically like an object now, uneditable object. Okay, so now go to plugins, Realflow, and you will need to download this plugin. You can download it on my website, and you have to download and install it before you actually start this tutorial. And once you install it, you have to restart your Cinema 4D. So yeah, sorry I didn't tell you that at the beginning of the tutorial, but anyways, once you have this plugin, go to this plugin, plugins, Realflow, select Realflow SD exporter, and select the object that you want to add to, that you want to export, and hit add, and it's gonna add this object. And now select the amount of frames you want to export, and select the file where you want to export this. So I'll just go desktop and I'll name it Frost, and I'll hit save, and then click export. Okay, now we have exported this object here. Now let's go into Realflow. Okay, in Realflow, name this project whatever you like. Alright, and select the file path where you wanna save this project. And this is important. You will need to remember where you save this project, or else this tutorial will not work. So memorize where you saved it, or save it where you can remember well, and hit create a new project. Then go to import object, and where you saved your object, your text, and select it and hit open, and it's gonna open this text that we created in Cinema 4D. And if you don't know how to move around in Realflow, you hold Alt and you use the buttons on your mouse to move around, and I'll let you guys figure that out. It'll take 5 minutes to figure that out. Anyways, now what you want to do is create an emitter by going into particle fluid menu and select whatever emitter you liked. I'll just select square. Alright, and with the square emitter selected, hit W on the keyboard, and this will allow you to move it around. Just move it into the middle of the text and a little bit above the text, and then hit R and enlarge it so that it's about as big as the text, and make it less wide so that it, not too much fluid is emitting from it. Okay, and hit W again and move it right over the text. Alright, now select the emitter and go to the node parameters, and in particles there's resolution. Change the resolution to 4. Viscosity, change that to 2, which will make it less viscous and it will be more like water. If you have it at 3 or 4, it will be more like a syrup than water. Anyways, now go to H random, change that to 0.5, and speed, change that to, no, actually keep it at 2, and just move it a little bit more above the text. All right and now go to, actually no, now let's just simulate it. So yeah, just select the emitter and hit simulate. Okay, and hit stop simulate at the point where you want the water to freeze. So stop simulate when you want the water to freeze. And now, and this is the whole trick of this tutorial, is to just simply stop the fluid where it's at, and it instantly freezes. So now let's create a render, or select a render kit. So right there in this mesh menu, select particle mesh render kit. Okay, and this is gonna include our emitter, which is this square emitter already in it. So select the particle mesh render kit, and in node parameters, change the polygon size to 0.03, and this is just basically gonna increase the quality of our mesh. Okay, now go to filters and select filter yes. Okay, and now go to frame 0 and select our particle mesh render kit, and click build meshes. Right here up in this corner it says build meshes, and I will be back as soon as this is done meshing. And something I want to mention is, don't stop the meshing once the fluid stops. So just keep on meshing while the fluid is not moving anymore. So that's basically the effect that we are trying to achieve, is meshing the fluid while it's stopped, and that's gonna give us this effect of ice. So it looks like ice. So yeah, I'll be back as soon as this is done. Okay, so I'm back and it's done meshing. So if we just scroll through the timeline, you can see it just, the fluid goes over the text and then it stops, just like in the intro. So that's pretty cool. Now we can go back to C4D, and once you're back in C4D, go to plugins, Realflow mesh importer, Realflow mesh importer, and select the file path where you saved the project from Realflow. In this case, it's computer, C users, and scenes, and where did I save it? Right there. And once you open the project, go to meshes and select particle mesh frame either 1 or 2. Don't select 0 or else it will not work, so select 1 or 2. I'll just select 2 and hit open. Okay, now if we go back to frame 0, here it starts going down and then it stops. So now finally what we need is a good lighting setup and also a good texture. And in this case I'll just be using ice texture, and you can't download this from anywhere. I have created this ice texture by myself, but I will be releasing a pro pack very soon, and you will be able to buy it. It's gonna be very cheap. It's gonna be like $10 or so, but it's gonna have like a lot of textures and a lot of really cool stuff in C4D, Photoshop, intro templates, pretty cool stuff. Anyways, let's put this texture over our mesh and also over our text. And now let's create a plane. Let's just tilt it like so and move it away and above the scene. And then create a material that's luminescent, that has luminance enabled, and drag it over our plane. And now let's try to render this and see what it looks like. So as you can see, that looks very similar to the intro, to the preview intro that I showed you guys. So here, if I render up close again, it kind of looks like ocean water, but yeah, it's just the texture, but it looks a lot like ice too. It looks like kind of clean ice that has no snow on it. So yeah, this is pretty much it for this tutorial. Thank you guys for watching. Please suggest your tutorials, or suggest tutorials that I should make, what I should show you guys, and please follow me on Twitter. There you can find the latest updates for my channel, what's happening on my channel, what kind of tutorials I'm gonna be making, what kind of videos I'm gonna be making. And there you can follow, and you can also suggest your ideas to my Twitter. So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and see you guys later.